The time is now. On everything. Took my heart away from money. I ain't interested in fame. And I pray that never change. Ambition is priceless. It's something that's in your veins. And I put that on my name.
Only hope I had was selling dope. Was on my grind cause times was harder than the cellar float. My mama taught me never steal and never tell them folks. I grew up looking up the niggas that was selling coke. Oh, I was raised by the stop sign. No religion, I was getting saved by the Glock 9. By the minute, I was getting paid like the hotline. Serving rolling, fiends was calling. We was dot com, well connected, well respected, and well protected. They took them like interceptions. So throw that pass, I'll be the cornerback. Me and Falar and MMG gonna bring that Warner back.
Alston does a very good job of sniffing it out and following the screener is exactly what he should do. But then to make the play on the football was the outstanding effort.
Easy to dream, a dream though it's harder to live.
Hey Sean, just want to say this, your strength and heart really encouraged us, man, and motivated us. It really helped us win this other Mountain West Championship game, emptying the bucket every week.
Essa, thank you for being the inspiration for your empty the bucket spirit that really drove us to the 2013 conference championship.
My ambition to win, just to get me some ends, help me pay my little rent, maybe sit in the bins. I saw mama praying as she wait on results. It was hot in the kitchen, can I wait on the porch? My father was missing, warlord Oliver North. Life was digging me deeper, I kept on coming up short. Breaking so many laws, waking up in the dark. Who cut my power off, it's time to move that powder soft. Woo. Not too many options when you coming from the project. Sitting in the trap, now you moving Cindy Lauper. Girls wanna have fun, and with some change. And I doubt that ever change. Ambition is priceless, that's something that's in your veins. And I doubt that ever change. Ambition is my, and I put that on my name. And I doubt that ever change.
For my ambition.
Shout out to my boy Sean. He was really the strongest man on our team. He came to 6 a.m. to camp, to every practice, and was ready to work. He emptied the bucket every day.
Easy to dream, a dream that was harder to live. They gon' love me for my ambition. Easy to dream, a dream that was harder to live. They gon' love me for my ambition. Beautiful music, painting pictures, it be my vision.
Well wishes to my opposition. You niggas probably cop a plea before you cop a pistol. I got nothing against them, they got potential. But every who can read gotta get his issue. Ralph.
Beautiful music, painting pictures, this be my vision. They gonna love me for my ambition.
Back inside Bulldog Stadium here at Fresno State. Sean Alston
had a career-ending shoulder surgery.
He was a defensive back for the Bulldogs. He told the team before the last season started, empty the bucket every day. And that really became a message for this Fresno State Bulldog team. And
beautiful music, painting pictures, this be my vision.
Yo, SA, this your boy.
They gonna love me for my ambition.
I just wanted to show you some love, man. Just tell you how proud I am of you. You're one of the few people who I know can go through what you went through, man, and keep the faith and stay strong and positive, man, and do it all with a smile on your face. I'm very proud of you, man.
So I just want everybody to know continue to work. We all got, like I said, we all got goals. We all got the same dream to get this championship. Empty the bucket every day. You know, go out to practice and do everything you can every day to get better, make your teammates better and all that stuff every day. Love you guys.
I'm going to keep it brief. You know, I planned on writing a whole speech and all that, but I didn't want to. I thought I was going to get nervous and mess around and start crying and stuff over here, so I ain't going. But, you know, March 4th, if for anybody who doesn't know, was a day that changed my life, you know, forever. You know, I went in normal practice, you know, trying to, you know, have fun out there with the sport I love. And, you know, I went in to make a tackle that turned out to be, you know, a freak accident. You know, none of the trainers had ever heard of it. I never heard of it. I went in to tackle him, and my whole body just went stiff. And then next thing I know, I can feel everything coming back, and except for my right arm. My arm just hangs. And I can remember them telling me to go sit down, wait for the practice to be over, and I just started bawling, crying, because all I have in my head is that image of me when I was just stuffed, like just stiff. And I remember coming back a couple hours later to the training room, and you know, them not knowing what was going on and going to the doctors, and I ended up having to go to Stanford to, you know, see a specialist up there. And he ends up telling me that, you know, you're not gonna be able to play this season. And so right then and there, I lost it, you know. I go from, you know, having conversations with, you know, with Deron, you know, thinking about having an opportunity, you know, playing the next level and stuff like that, and then to have something like that happen to me and be told that, you know, I'm gonna be done playing football was the hardest thing I've ever dealt with in my life to this day. And, you know, I, you know, tried to be strong, and, you know, I remember crying to my roommates and crying to teammates and stuff like that, and just not knowing where I was gonna go. And, you know, my own teammates, you know, friends and family had more faith in me than I had faith in myself. And, you know, still to this day, I'm left with, you know, my arm just hanging around. So when people say, what's up, how's your arm? I just say, just hanging around, you know, like a joke. But, you know, like I said, you go from, you know, playing the sport that you love the whole time to just being taken away from you was, in the blink of an eye, was just outrageous to me. You know, I could have went home, you know, coaches were telling people to go home because, you know, you had a traumatic injury and stuff like that, but, you know, there was nothing back home for me to go to, you know what I mean? Wanted to finish, you know, graduate, and, you know, still be around my teammates and stuff like that, because they were the ones who kept me, you know, kept me humble, kept me strong, kept me, you know, around and stuff like that. And, you know, just want everybody to know, you know, embrace it. Embrace the game you play, embrace everything you do, because in the blink of an eye, you know, you never know when it's going to be over. You know, friends and, you know, your parents always tell you, you know, your stuff's going to come to an end. Your sport's going to come to an end. Nobody's going to, you know, play baseball forever, run track forever, basketball, any sport. You're not going to do it forever. And so, you know, just when that time does come, you know, just make sure you went out with a bang when you didn't do it. And that's why I'm glad I still have my days, of course, when I'm down and stuff like that. But, you know, I can say that I had one whole season of college and I enjoyed myself. And even then, the next year, I had a different role on my team and all that stuff. So, you know, you just make sure you go out with a bang. And, you know, I love everybody out here who supported me and who kept me strong and had me, you know, being there for me. You know, shout out to Ruby's, Greg, Deron, you know, Hank being here. Shout out to my team, DBs, you know, everybody who's been there for me, supporting me. And love you guys. And I'll see you guys around.